Hello everyone, this is the second online history tutorial for class 7. We are going to continue with the first chapter from the section Region and Empire. Let's begin. Now we know that big empires like the Cholas, the Delhi Sultanate and the Mughals encompassed a large area of the subcontinent. A Sanskrit prashasti praised Ghiyasuddin Balban and mentioned the extent of his empire from Bengal in the east to Ghazni in Afghanistan in the west. Historians usually believe that these claims were exaggerated and try to make sense of why these claims were exaggerated, why rulers used to claim these things and claim that they encompassed large regions, they conquered large regions. By 700 AD, most of the subcontinent had different languages, different cultures in different places. They were also associated with different and specific ruling dynasties. There was considerable conflict between the states. Occasionally, dynasties like the Cholas, the Khiljis, the Mughals, they conquered these small regions and ruled a pan-Indian empire. Pan-Indian means encompassing almost the whole of India. Not all these empires were equally stable though. The thousand years of history that we are exploring witnessed major changes in religious traditions. These changes happened in Hinduism. This is the period where most of the changes happened in Hinduism as we know today. These changes included the worshipping of new deities, the worshipping of new gods, the construction of temple by kings. The Brahmins grew more important in the society. They became the dominant group of the society because their knowledge of Sanskrit. Only the Brahmins had the knowledge of Sanskrit because they were the highest order in the society. One of the major developments in this period was the emergence of the bhakti tradition, of a loving personal god that devotees could reach without the aid of the Brahman priest or elaborate rituals. This was also the period where a new religion appeared in the Indian subcontinent, that was Islam. Islam was brought to India by the Muslim merchants, the Arab merchants from Arabia who had Quran as their holy book. Muslims believed that the Quran contains the word of the God. They believed in one God who they called Allah. Many rulers were patrons of the Islamic tradition. Many rulers were Islamic in their beliefs and they were patrons of Islam. But just like Hinduism, Islam also had many differences within itself. There was the Shia Islam, there was the Sunni Islam, there was Hanafi Islam, there was the Shafi Islam and many more. The study of time is made somewhat easier by the periodization of history. In the middle of 19th century, British historians divided Indian history into three broad segments: the Hindu period, the Muslim period, and the British period. This division was based on the idea that only the religion of the ruler mattered and nothing else was important. Of course, this is not true. Most historians do not follow this partition today. They look at economic and social changes to denote divisions in Indian historical time period. So we have basically finished the first chapter. In the third tutorial video, we will be starting the second chapter of your syllabus. Till then, bye.